शंकर भगवान की प्रेम सोलो सरस्वती माता की प्रेम सोलो महावीर स्वामी की एंड फाइनली माय डियर फ्रेंड्स बिफोर वी जॉइन टुगेदर इन ब्यूटीफुल कथा ऑफ आवर लॉर्ड लेट्स ऑल जॉइन टुगेदर इन सिंगिंग द प्रेजेस ऑफ आवर बिलव्ड गुरुजी Srimati Mataji Sandra, always sitting so far, but yet you can feel her vibration wherever she is. Tonight, my dear sisters and brothers, we're here to celebrate this young man's 75th birthday. What an accomplishment, eh? He has reached a stage now in his life where he sits and he reflects on his life, his achievements, his accomplishments. And also he looks back at moments when we became very disappointed. When we reach certain age, my dear friends, certain ages like 75, this is special. This is not an ordinary age. As a matter of fact, he's at the point now where he's entering the last stage now. And it is described as sannyasi. Sannyasi means you will learn more of that tonight in my presentation. Everybody know what the word dharma is? Dharma, Sanatan dharma, Dulsi's dharma, Jenny's dharma, Pandit Deepak's dharma. It means your duties, religious merits, so many definitions. But it represents our duties in life. And I want to share a few things with you here before, as I begin my katha. There are a few dharmas which we perform, or we ought to, we should perform in our life, while we have the ability, the health and strength to do so. So in other words, we all have our duties. We feel husband, wife, children, all of this is our duties and so forth. But it goes beyond that. You ever heard the word Varna Ashram Dharma? I think Panaji would have heard that. Mataji, Sanjay could attest to this. It is called our duties towards the four ashrams, the four stages of man's life. And everybody know what they are, right? Good. Brahmachari, say that. You're a little better than that. Good. Then you have Grihast Ashram. Then you have Vanprast. And then you have Sannyas. So these are the four ashrams. They're described as the four stages of life which we enter into if we're blessed. Don't forget that one. Tonight, my dear friends, man has his or her duties towards these four ashrams. But I will get back to that one. Say panch. No. I was shoveling snow today and I'm a little bit clogged up. So you have to speak up. Panch. Maha. Yagya. Everybody know what that one is, right? You do? Good. These are the five yagyas, the five forms of sacrifices which man needs to do every day in life. This is education now, you know. These are things we should be doing. And the question is, do we do them? The first one is called Brahma or Rishi Yagya. That simply means to at least some time of the day read a religious scripture. How many of us do that? Raise your hand. How many of us read the daily news? Everybody. New York Times, everybody. Huh? And the Lord is telling us here that at least once a day, need I say all day? At least a few moments of the day, pick up a religious scripture and read and educate yourself, enlighten yourself. So that is Brahma or Rishi Yagya. Then we have Deva Yagya, paying homage to the Lord. And listen how easy this one is. This one here, you don't need to fast, you don't need to check patra, or you don't need to phone a friend or a pandit. All you need to do is wake up every morning and says, Lord, thank you for the opportunity to live to see another day. That is the greatest prayer man can recite any portion of the day, any time of your life. Thank you, Lord, for allowing me to rise to live to see another day. Our eyes open. From the time our eyes open, we become angry at the world. The clock, what a poor clock do? What the poor lady do you in the bed? Nothing. What the child do you? Nothing. But we become so angry. The Lord is saying here, at least every morning, thank you, Lord. This is the greatest prayer you can recite. Pitri Yagya, paying homage to our ancestors. How many of us remember our ancestors? Our parents who have passed on. Our nanas, our ajas, our ajis. Remembering them. Without them, my dear sisters and brothers, this school, this relationship, this family, where would you be? What would you be? All the contributions they have made, it is for our benefit. Today we are reaping it. So at least once a day, oh man, remember your foreparents. Bhut Yagya. Bhut Yagya means to pay homage to lower animals. Animals, imagine? The cow, the donkey, the rat, the mouse, the duck, the chicken. Pay homage. Kya baat? The Lord is saying, at least once a day, you must show, give some rice. When you take out food, when you do pitri again, all these things, we're taking out food. Who are you giving the food to? The animals, they enjoy it. So at least once a day, oh man, take out little food now. The half bagel, you know, eat your chow, break it up and throw it in the road. You will see how an animal will be so happy to eat that bagel with Swiss cheese. My favorite. Manoj Yagya. Manoj Yagya means paying homage, respect, and honor to your fellow men. So this is described as the Panch Maha Yagya, the five daily yajna sacrifices which we should do every day. Reading scriptures, paying homage to the Lord, remembering our ancestors, paying homage to lower animals, and of course, showing respect, love, and honor to your fellow man. That's number two, Panch Maha Yagya. Then we have Kul Dharma, duties towards our families. And tonight I honor my father for dedicating this first session to his siblings and their families. And tonight I'm sure he's overwhelmed with joy to have them sitting with him to remember and to rehash those beautiful moments and memories which they have shared together. The Lord reminds us in our scriptures that man, you have your duties towards your family. Desh Dharma. How many of us have heard of this one? Desh means your country. We have our duties towards our country. my dear brothers and sisters. Huh? The sanitation man has his duties to do. The accountant, the housewife, you name it, we all have our duties to perform for the countries in which we live. Without us, the countries cannot survive. So don't do this thing because of the president. The president can't get there until you put him in. He can't just open the door to the White House and walk in and say, I am president now. No. We have duties all to fulfill, my dear friends. And finally, we have what is called Atma Dharma. Atma Dharma means this is your duties towards the soul, the Atma, which is the highest form we have been blessed with in this life. So tonight we have learned of these forms of dharmas which we perform. Now my father has entered into a new stage in his life, which is described as the Varna Ashram Dharma, the four stages. Now, before I delve into this katha, we have heard of the four stages, right? Brahmachari, Grihast Ashram, Vanprast, and you have Sannyas. Now look how our saints and sages have put it. From 1 to 25, Brahmachari, student life.